안녕하세요, 데니입니다. 오늘은 이제 소주토크 4화를 촬영하려고 시작을 했고요. 함께하고 있는 티아고와 비톨. 네, 오늘 함께 촬영을 해주려고 왔고요. 3화에서는 이제 한국인들한테 LGBTQ+에 대한 생각을 물어봤었어요. 4화에서는 한국에 살고 있는 브라질 친구들한테 LGBTQ+가 브라질이랑 한국에서 문화가 어떻게 다르고 어떤 변화가 더 서로에게 필요할지 그런 부분에 대해서 이야기를 해보고자 이렇게 브라질 친구들을 모아봤고요. 이렇게 한번 LGBTQ+에 관해서 브라질 친구들에게 이야기를 물어보고 한국인 친구들한테도 얘기해주고 싶은 게 있는지 뭐 그런 것까지 이어지는 그런 인터뷰를 진행해보도록 하겠습니다. From now on, I will ask you guys questions one by one. Okay. Is it alright?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Okay, first question. Is there like any action that makes you think like that person is gay for sure? Like Koreans say holding back like this looks gay. A lot of makeups looks gay to Koreans. I don't know to Brazilians, but to Koreans it looks gay.
I think the perspective in Brazil and Korea is quite different, I guess. Because in Brazil, just the fact that you're wearing makeup or you're holding a purse itself is already kind of considered gay by society. So I don't know, Brazilians kind of a little bit more kind of homophobic on this point. Like men are not as allowed to look for beauty the way that Koreans do, even to express feelings and hug friends, even like the skin touch, which is really common in Korea. For Brazilians, it's seen as a gay thing already. So I don't know, when I come to Korea, it's actually kind of, it's awkward because it's difficult to know who is gay and who is not in the beginning. Because for us, like, if you take it in consideration, these facts that happen in Brazil, like, most people look kind of gay, like, kind of more feminine. Because we have, like, this macho culture in Brazil, I guess. Yeah, here it's kind of different, I guess. It's, like, difficult to say who is not and who it is.
How about you? Is there anything, any special action that makes you think that person is gay?
It's really hard to tell here in Korea because when someone is gay, because usually, as he said, like, when people in Brazil, like, especially men wear makeup or are wearing a purse, it's usually, like, certain that, you know, that most likely this person is gay. But here in Korea it's much more like social accepted for men to wear makeup, to have purses, and so that's why I don't know, like I see a lot of men wearing makeup here in Korea, so I couldn't tell if they're gay or not. Most Korean men that I've been on dates with, they were like they could be pretty much like a straight guy because they look like every single guy I've seen here in Korea. They don't have like specific behavior that makes them look gay or like associate them with the stereotype of gay, so pretty hard here in Korea to say like if someone's gay, if someone's not. But if anything of those things happen in Brazil, like you see guys wearing makeup, people would certainly think that they're gay. Like you would know right away.
Even like the fashion.
Yeah, even fashion, like clothes that sometimes men wear here in Korea would be like gay outfits in Brazil. Yeah.
What kind of outfit? Like skinny jeans?
Yeah. Skinny jeans depends, but like short shorts, that's usually really a gay thing in Brazil.
Yeah. The colorful
t-shirts.
Yeah, like the flowerish things.
Yeah, a lot of flowers. Like a lot of stamps that would be like, I mean, it's cultural here in Korea. Yeah. Men are used to like have more colors on their outfits. In Brazil, wouldn't be that common.
Got it. How about like makeups? I put on the BB every time.
BB cream.
Yeah, BB cream.
Okay.
If I put it in Brazil, will they think I'm gay?
Pretty much. Yeah. If you say like, oh, I'm using BB cream, pretty much. Yeah.
Seriously?
Yeah. I think no straight guys in Brazil, even though they wanted to, they wouldn't feel comfortable putting it on because people would think that they're gay. Mm.
That's the thing. Like, Brazil creates a stereotype that even though you're not gay and it has nothing to do with your sexual orientation, you're not really allowed by society to do this. I mean, you can do it if you want, but most people would not. Just like you said, they wouldn't have the courage to do it because they would be judged. So
not even that they will be judged, but like they feel probably themselves that they shouldn't be doing it because like makeup is for women.
How about like, I'm just curious, sun creams with some colors.
I don't think guys in Brazil are even like caring about putting sunscreen without any color.
Seriously?
Like, yeah.
Skincare in Brazil?
Yeah. Like, especially for men, like mostly, they wouldn't like even care about putting sunscreen. That's the thing, like here in Korea, men are really like taking care of their skin, like of appearance. Yeah. Men are pretty much in Brazil just wake up like this and go that way without even sun cream, not really caring about that.
That's interesting.
More cultural. I think sun cream is more like cultural, like habits. Cultural than like something that you would think like, oh, people think I'm gay if I'm wearing sunscreen.
That's really interesting.
Maybe they use it if they go to the beach only.
But like that's true. Even when I did like face mask, my first time was in Korea because I never even imagined about doing face mask in Brazil because it was, I don't know, I
Yeah, skincare products in Brazil are not that widespread.
Seriously?
Right now, we're getting a lot of stuff from Korea, Japan, China. They're getting popular, but you don't find them as much as you find here in Korea.
You might find a guy that does skincare and this kind of stuff in Brazil. It's not that doing like facials, for example. It's not that uncommon. However,
they do it in secret, probably.
Not even hide, but it's something that is starting to change.
Yeah, wow. slowly it's changing. Yeah.
So it's similar to Korea. Like 10 years ago in Korea, we couldn't have the makeup at all.
Oh, really?
Yeah, oh, really?
Yeah, really.
I don't think about makeup. Maybe skincare treatment could be something in Brazil, but makeup for men, I think it's still something pretty much a bit far. I mean, maybe 10 years from now, I don't know.
Yeah, 10 years.
Just like in Korea.
True.
Mm-hmm.
Got it. Okay, second question. Do you guys think Korea is less open to LGBTQ+ culture compared to Brazil?
That's complicated question.
Yeah,
because I feel like in Korea the society is still pretty traditional, but I think the biggest difference is more like physical security, physical safety, because in Brazil either you also have a really traditional society, a lot of people are pretty open to it, even though like the people who are not really open to it, they could be willing to harm you physically. Here in Korea, even though like a lot of people don't really accept it, don't really understand it, you don't feel like unsafe, like you don't feel like anyone is gonna come and kill you because you're gay. In Brazil, you have a more of an open society towards homosexuality, but the part that is not that open, you fear them because they might hurt you in some way physically. So I think Korea is more close than Brazil, but the physical safety here in Korea is much stronger than I would feel in Brazil, definitely. Even though people don't accept me, I'm not like fearing that they're gonna kill me or do anything with me.
It's kind of like what he said. I think both countries are actually close if you think about it, but in different ways. Korea is more close in the way that I think it comes maybe from collectivism, like you think about the society itself, so you don't want to harm the traditional society because the society itself is traditional and you don't want to break that thing. Because of that, most people just hide in a way. If they're working in some company, they might not say like, oh, I'm gay or I'm lesbian, I'm transsexual or whatever. They will not come out, you know. But in Brazil, you see people coming out because I think Brazilian people like to carry that flag, like yes, we are like this. But at the same time, it's like he says, it's completely different, because even though you might lose your job here and stuff, in Brazil you might as well, but it's more safe to be LGBTQ here, pretty sure. Even though there are some cases, transsexual people being beaten on the street by drunk ajushis or some stuff like that, but it's like so rare compared to Brazil, which is like 1.5 hour one homosexual die or something like that.
Seriously, that bad?
A lot of people die in Brazil because of homosexuality. I mean, not homosexuality, but like their own sexual orientation.
I'm not sure about the hours exactly. I said 1.5, but it's like
it's a lot. It's like I think something per hour, something like this, like every 4 hours one LGBTQ dies in Brazil because of its sexual orientation. Like he said, like maybe here in Korea people are like, they are okay with their sexuality, they don't have like a problem, but they just don't say it out loud, maybe because of the thing, like one society thing. That could be also a reason why people here in Korea are more close about talking about homosexuality and like being more inside the closet. Yes,
that's sad.
Yeah,
people dying.
Yeah, people die, people don't open themselves.
Just by the official data, we are the country that most kill LGBTQ people in the world. By the official unofficial people, there's a lot of people dying and we don't even know.
But still, there are so many Brazilian people who should come out as LGBT people, even though they will be in danger.
It's because the LGBT movement is rising a lot in Brazil right now. People cannot stop talking about it anymore. I don't know, people in Brazil embrace this flag. Even people that are not from the LGBT community, they still embrace this flag and talk about it. We have this thing in Brazil that we have to talk about social issues. Not like here in Korea, like you know you are gay, but you're not talking to people that you are, because I mean, could be better that way. Wouldn't raise like those kind of topics in the society in Brazil. We should talk about those things. So I think that's the main difference probably too.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
Let's move on to third one.
Yeah.
If you are a Korean and a gay, is it gonna be harder to tell others that you are gay compared to Brazil?
Comes to the previous topic. Like if you say here in Korea that you're gay, even if you say it to someone that doesn't accept it or doesn't like it, it's not like you're gonna fear they're gonna kill you, because even though they don't accept it, they had like good base education, they had a good life, they don't need to necessarily kill you. Maybe they won't accept you, which is also awful, not only because they're not gonna kill you, that it's not a bad thing, but mostly I think that it's always difficult when someone says he doesn't accept you for who you are. The main difference in Korea and Brazil is that maybe maybe in Brazil you'd fear for your life. Here in Korea, not as much. But even though you don't fear for your life, you still like have this thing that you're not gonna be accepted for society. Even though it's not, it couldn't be like dangerous for your life, still bad. But I mean, I've met a lot of people in Korea. I've heard a lot of stuff before coming to Korea that Korea was pretty traditional society, that it wasn't like widely accepted. But mostly people that I met here, none of them had really a problem with this. Probably because they were younger people. So I think the younger generation is pretty much accepting LGBTQ people more than like oldery. But even though I heard like Korean man saying stuff about gay people, but like there was just once in a club. I think like younger generation is pretty much accepting. So I think maybe 30 years from now, this won't be like such a huge thing like it is today.
Yeah, like 30 years later.
Yeah.
I will be 50 years old.
Yeah, you'll be 50 years old. Yeah, and the older we will be probably dead.
Yeah. Okay, so it's hard to choose.
Yeah, it's hard to choose, but
So can you choose if you have to choose?
Quite difficult because I believe maybe the social pressure here is... Mm-hmm. It's difficult to say if it's stronger or not because it's like Peter says, in Brazil, you're kind of fearing for your life in some way. And you know, it's pretty common if you hear stories about LGBTQ people in Brazil, the parents just throw them away at home and they end up having to living with friends. And it's pretty common still, unfortunately. When there are even cases of people there, the parents actually killed the
children.
The children. Yeah, it happened a few times. So I think not even a few times. I think it happens sometimes. So it's kind of creepy. But at the same time, I understand also that when you're raised with this vision, you need to respect other people. Whatever you do, you're doing this not to yourself. It's not like individually, you're doing this to everyone around you. So I believe that the pressure here is really strong, especially when you start looking for the family nucleus of Korean like traditional houses and it's like you kind of feel more, at least in my perspective, I feel like that children usually they feel like that they should give something back to their parents in a way more than in Brazilian society, I guess. But it's really hard to say which one is, but
it's all right.
Yeah.
So it's hard to choose.
Yeah, it's hard.
But let's move on to the first one then.